Welcome to my first video of video series for emergency pediatric viva for examination registration practice medicine in Sri Lanka, that is for ERPM. But still, these videos will be golden for all the medical students and house officers, those who are practically involved in emergency treatment in the ward setup. Usually in emergency pediatric viva in ERPM, examiner will give you a scenario, or he will show you up some instrument and he will have an initiation to the exam. Here, this is the scenario he will give you as an example. He will tell you like this: "All right, son, it's your casualty day in your ward. You are sleeping in your quarters since there's no admission, but you get a call to your landline. Nurse speak from the ward and she tell you like this: 'Doctor, hadisi patient kenek kavilla innawa usma ganne amaruwen patient ge vayasa maasa 7ak vithara wenawa podi babek anikmanta ward ekata enna.' So this is the scenario. He will ask you what you will do. Now your answer. First, you will have to say, first of all, 'Sir, I will reach the situation soon as possible.' Right? That has to be there. Then, if you can add something to differ from others, say like, you have to live in the situation of emergency situation. You just have to possess yourself. Now you are in this situation and say something like this: 'So I will run to the ward and I will attend this soon as possible.' Right? Make it unique. Your answer, make it unique. Then your answer continues: 'When I reach the ward, I'll get this patient and the bystander to the emergency room. While I'm taking to the emergency room, I would like to ask the short history from the bystander.' Then he will say, your examiner might say, 'All right, this is the history. I'm the father of the patient and I'm saying to you, doctor, putata podi hembirisawa gatiyak thibba. Hotu aawa dawas deka thunak api ilanga doctor gen behed gatta. E unata ekaparama me usma gann eka wedi una. Podda podda wedi wegena den godakma amaru wenawa ekaparama.' This is the history. He is telling what you will do next. 'All right, sir, I will take this patient to the emergency room. I will connect him to the pulse oximeter.' What is the word? You have to remember, pulse oximeter. You have to have a proper knowledge of pulse oximeter. For that, you just have to refer to that and you have to see the photos of it. You have to get familiar with what it measures. Usually it gives you, see the name of that pulse oximeter, it will give you pulse. Also, it will give you respiratory rate, saturation, and blood pressure, those things. So I will connect him to the pulse oximeter. Meanwhile, I'm doing that, I will ask one of nurse to contact my immediate senior. You have to remember, immediate senior, and tell him the situation and to come to the ward soon till I do the management. That is also should be there. Then you have to tell your examiner, so since I have connected him to the already to the pulse oximeter, I will assist his airway breathing circulation. What are the words? Airway breathing circulation. In assessing of airway, I would like to make sure his airway is patent. If there are any, say, nasal secretion, I would like to suck them out with using yanker sucker. What is that? You have to remember the name, yanker sucker. Yanker suction tube and the machine, right? Because you have to know, when you suck them the secretion out, when you suck the secretion out, the patient immediately will respond. If there is a significant airway obstruction by the secretion, there will be improvement, certain improvement. You will have to say that. If you say that, he knows you are so familiar with this emergency setup. Then assessing breathing circulation, you don't have to name breathing and circulation separately. You just go ahead say, if the saturation is less than 92%, what is the value? 92%. You will have to remember those significant value with your memory stimulator. What is the memory stimulator? As an example, I remember that 92%. I used the little method thinking that if I don't smoke occasionally, I will not have any breathing difficulties at 92 of age. When I am 92 years, I will not have any breathing difficulty. That is my the memory stimulator. You will have to remember, you will have to use some sort of a memory stimulator which suits you. and then remember. So if there is a 92%, if there is a less than 92% of saturation, I will give humidified oxygen. What you will give? Humidified oxygen via face mask and reservoir bag. You will have to use this word, via face mask and reservoir bag. You are not using nasal prong. Nasal prong will deliver around 2 liters. So this is not your, this is not the thing you are using in emergency. You are using mask with reservoir bag, 6 to 8 liters of oxygen. All right. Then proper evaluation of his airway breathing circulation and making it stable. I would like to go into the little details of the history from the bystander. Then your examiner may speak up saying, all right, this patient is having respiratory rate 60 and he is tachycardic and he is having subcostal and intercostal recessions. You go ahead with your treatment. What would you do? So since this is involving of respiratory system, I would go into respiratory examination, quick respiratory examination. I will find out what is there. Alright, then your examiner may speak up. He's having bilateral air crackers with reduced airway bilaterally. What would you do? Then sir, with my examination finding, I would like to go into a probable diagnosis and treat this patient. The examiner might ask you, what is your probable diagnosis? Sir, my probable diagnosis is moderate bronchiolitis. Why are you thinking of moderate bronchiolitis? Because the history that the bystander told, which was preceded by coryza-like illness and the age 7 months, the bronchiolitis is mainly, majority of age group affected around 2 to 8 months. Therefore, with this examination finding, I would like to have my probable diagnosis of moderate bronchiolitis and treat this patient. Then your examiner might ask, what are the treatment? Now you are going to do till your senior reached the ward. Even though it is not the treatment of choice, I would like to go ahead with nebulization of this kid to relieve his symptoms. Here I will use ipratropium bromide 125 mcg. With salbutamol 2.5 milligram, with normal saline, 3% normal saline nebulizes. What are you using? What are you using to nebulize? Remember, 125 micrograms of ipratropium bromide, 2.5 milligram of salbutamol with 3% of normal saline nebulizes that you are using to nebulize this child. I will nebulize with this and 20 minutes after nebulization, I will reassess the patient. If patient is not improving, I will go ahead with back to back 3 times of nebulization, that you can tell. Then your examiner may ask, alright, you have finished your 3 times of nebulization, but still your senior hasn't reached the ward. But this is just for the drama, your senior may reach you soon as possible. This is just a drama, this is just a scenario, he's just putting up the things to check your knowledge. In that case, what would you do? You have to tell, if the nebulization was not relieving his symptoms, I would consider nebulizing with adrenaline. Adrenaline 1 in 1000, 0.5 ml per kg. That you can go up to 5 milliliter maximum. I will try nebulization with adrenaline, you will have to say. Alright, then the examiner may ask, alright, then now your senior has reached the ward. You have this you have nebulized the child, but child has not improved. What are you suggesting your senior may do, or you are suggesting your senior, let's do this? What are you suggesting? What are your suggestion? If patient is not improving nebulization, I would like to consider of giving high flow oxygen. That you will have to remember, there is an instrument for deliver high flow oxygen. You have to check on that as well. Then your examiner may ask, all right, you went through this high flow oxygen, but still the patient is not having much of improvement. What are the investigation you suggest to do? Then you can check his x-ray. Why are you taking the x-ray? To check any lung pathologies behind this scenario. You can take his ECG and get done echocardiography. Why are you doing that? Because to find out any congenital heart diseases or any sort of a heart diseases, heart pathology supported this condition. Also, you can check his blood gases. I think this will be more than enough for your ERPM viva, but if he goes into more details, like if he wants to give you more marks, he may ask you further question. He will ask you, all right, now all the investigation seems to be worsening. What you can do next, if the patient is cyanosed, if the patient is not responding, if the patient is severely dyspneic after all this treatment, what you can do now? Just give me a clue. You can consider off intubation the patient. What are the indications for intubation the patient? If the patient is cyanosed, if the patient is not resolving with the earlier treatment, if you are doing repeatedly, if the patient having reduced off consciousness, those are the indication you may consider, but do not go ahead with those treatment. You always tell, you will get your senior opinion prior doing this. By saying so, you are confirming that you are a player of emergency pediatric, but still you are bearing safe hands that you have to convey to your examiner to show you are a safe guy to deal in the ward. All right, that's it. That's all from my end. I request you to watch this video and get your things like in this way to get familiar, to get yourself versatile for emergency pediatric viva. If you are doing this, there are no way you will fail your exam. There's a high chance you will score even more than 80, 90, I don't know. You will be a player of emergency medicine, emergency pediatrics. If you like this video, you just like it. If you have any clarification, you just comment it. If you are selfless on knowledge, please share for your friends can benefit. Till my next emergency pediatric video, I ask you to subscribe to this channel and stick with me. Bye bye till then.